All right, so what's up, YouTube? It is December 9th, the weekend. It's the weekend, baby, and it's yours truly, the real DJ Red with two D's. Getting ready to load up right now. I'm not using my van this weekend. I know my van wasn't working right. Came to the conclusion that I believe I might have some bad gas in there. When I put the gas in, I believe it was last week, Friday, soon as I put it in, there was nothing but problems after that. I've changed several things on that so far. So after the weekend, I'm going to drain the gas. Right now, we're in the U-Haul, which is fine. I got a lot of running around to do, and I'd rather have something reliable. I'm not worried about the mileage too much. I'd rather worry about making sure that my clients are satisfied. As you see, I got the Behringer rack there. I will be pulling her out on Sunday. I was tempted to pull it out tonight, but I'm gonna pull it out on Sunday. I'm gonna use the powered system tonight. All the EVs, getting those off the shelf right now. I got some that I'm putting on the, already put on the truck. I decided, let me stop, make a quick video real quick. So we got a party tonight for one of the fraternities, grad chapters, Omega Psi Phi Fraternity, Eta Nu Chapter, and also Delta Sigma Theta Sorority, South Broward Alumni Chapter. They're doing a big holiday party tonight. Then tomorrow we have the Winterfest Boat Parade. Sunday we got the toy drive and cookout out on Broward Regional Park. We're doing that with Weeting Radio, which I play for them Tuesdays and Thursdays. And then Sunday night we got a corporate gig, so very busy weekend. Follow me all the way through. All right, so forgive me for the lighting. I'm walking from where my truck is parked at to get my equipment around in the front, and we are at the Bahia Mar Resort. Ooh, lighting real bad. Okay, just bear with me as we get inside here. Already made two trips upstairs. This is the last round here with the cart, a couple of lights and stuff that we're taking upstairs, and we're gonna do a before picture before the up lights and after the up lights. There we go. All right, so made it up in here. As you can see, I got everything on the floor behind me. Let's take a look at the room real quick before we do the lights. Okay, so there's a stage. They already got a table for me. Nice size stage, nice size room. Alright, so that's before the up lights and before the setup. This is all the equipment here. Let's get everything set up. I got 2 hours to do it. Expecting anywhere from, I'm gonna say at least 300 people. So let's get everything going. All right, so once again, this DJ Red, I'm done setting up. Got everything done in time. Taped out my wires, the ones that in the doorway and stuff like that. Got all the up lights up that they wanted. So let's take a look at everything now.
Yeah.
So what's up YouTube? I'm just finishing up this video vlog from this past weekend. Parts of the video that you've seen that the guests were up close to me, that was from Saturday night from the Winterfest boat parade. And that was a real good party. Friday night was good with them at the Bahamar Hotel, but Saturday night was even better. I like when my guests are up close to me. You can feel their energy. They can feel my energy. And we feed off of each other's energy like that. When I'm up on the stage, I feel kind of distant sometimes. Kind of like playing in a DJ booth and not really being close up to your guests that you want to be close up to. Also, there was probably a couple of pictures in there with Evander Holyfield. Yes, he was aboard our boat. From what I was told by other guests and spectators from the Winterfest boat parade, we were the loudest, the livest yacht along the entire intercoastal. I believe there might have been maybe 60 or so boats that came through, and we were the loudest from what I've heard. I do plan on doing this again next year. Hopefully the weather works with us or cooperates with us a little bit better, but hey, this is South Florida. For those of you that live down here, you know how the weather is. It could be sunny now, 10 minutes later it could be storming outside, and it could be raining across the street and be sunny over on this side. Y'all know how it is. And then the other event that you've probably seen, my big system, that was a toy drive from the WeTingRadio.com radio station, that I DJ on twice a week. We did a toy drive on that. Big Chiny, DJ Big Chiny, did the grilling on the food, and we had fun out there. It wasn't a real big turnout. Again, the weather kind of was bad on that, but the cause was more important, so we did that as well. And then later on that night, we did the party for a Home Depot Christmas party. I didn't get much footage of that. I did try to go Facebook Live on that. For some reason, it got deleted. I did get the footage for the Junkanoo band that was there. It was a Caribbean style party. It ended up real good. Now, the only bad thing to that whole weekend was, my downside to this weekend was, when I got ready to leave Home Depot's party, I got blocked in by a budget truck. I was in a U-Haul and there was a budget truck that was parked in front of me. I couldn't get out. No one knew who the truck belonged to. Let's just say I will never get myself in that predicament again. The party was over at 12 o'clock. By the time I was done packing up, I probably got downstairs to the loading area maybe about 1:15. No one knew who the truck belonged to. Let's just say I was stuck out there for a while. I had to call Budget to come and tow the truck in order for me to get out of there. And that did not happen until around after 4 a.m. by the time I got to my warehouse to unload the U-Haul truck, try to get the U-Haul truck back to U-Haul. Plus, I had to stop to refuel it, had to put the gas back where it was at. The sun was already up. I did not get home until 8 o'clock that morning. That was the only side to it. But I did call the company. I did find out who the truck belonged to later on. I called them and I spoke to the one of the co-owners of the company, and he was like, well, no, I appreciate you not yelling at me. Fly in my mouth. Honestly, I was so tired and I had so much fun this weekend. I had no energy to argue with him or anyone else. I had more than enough fun this weekend with the men of Ada Nu Chapter Omega Sci-Fi Fraternity and the women of Delta Sigma Theta Sorority South Broward Alumni Chapter. I seen a lot of people from Florida Memorial University that was there as well. I had a really, really good time this weekend. I was in no mood to argue with anyone or anything like that. It was a sad situation that I got home so late and I got stuck or whatever. But overall, I still had a great, great time this weekend. I did what I love doing, and you know, there you go from there. I give this weekend, I got to hold the phone with one hand, but hey, go one thumb up for this side, one thumb up for this side. But I really had a great time this weekend. This weekend coming up, we are getting ready for another busy weekend. Starting on Thursday, have a Board of Trustees Christmas party for Florida Memorial University. Doing that Thursday, and Friday I have two events also. Saturday I have two events also. So another great busy weekend coming up. I've been thinking over the last couple of days, I do need to get some more help. The help that I did have right now is tied up with some other things. So I'm looking to get another roadie to help me out for this coming year, for 2017. Someone reliable. And, again, it's been a good weekend. I got another good weekend coming up. Make sure you share, subscribe, follow. You know, if you want to leave comments down, you can leave comments down there. But don't leave your vehicle parked in a loading dock and get blocked in like I did. It was a very, I had plenty of energy then because I was on the Red Bull. I was ready to go home, but I didn't have no energy to argue after I was done. Anyway, make sure you subscribe, follow, and share. Peace.